Hey guys, today we're going to be working on a commercial utility cargo vehicle. And these were military vehicles, and they were called the CUC-V for, you know, the acronym. But these are really cool. Now this one belongs to Jared, and I really like these things. Now what they were was a light duty support vehicle. And these were available at Army, Air Force, Marines. Everybody had these in every branch of the military. And I really like these. And although these were made with mostly civilian stuff, they had a lot of heavy duty suspension and equipment. Like instead of half ton or three quarter ton, these are like 5/4 ton. So they're a little over a ton. But yeah, they got these tow hooks at the front, two in the front, and two in the back. They came with two in the back. And this is a blackout light. This is pretty cool. Well, this is a number tag. This is the blackout light. Now, that's pretty cool. It just shines a small beam of light on the vehicle right in front of you so you can run with no headlights on at night and not be seen from the air, you know. If you get seen from the air, that's bad. The enemy planes could take you out. But yeah, this is a eight lug hub. This has got the lock in, lock out. And it looks like this belongs to Jared. He's got him some pink shocks on there. And you know, man runs pink shocks on his military vehicle. He's pretty secure with his sexuality. This is the blackout light control switch, and I'm just going to show you a little on the interior. This is a diagnostic connector, and I guess that's a horn button. That's where radio should go. But, yeah, these things were pretty cool, and they were built as a support vehicle. Not really something you'd want to take up out on the front line, because these are not armored, so, you know, there's no bulletproof glass or anything in them. But, you know, mostly the features, like, get this pintle hook over here. Now, these are cool for towing military trailers and stuff. Heavy duty. And that's another heavy duty outfit there. Some sort of trailer light connector. And looks like Jared's missing some pintle hooks. I think he said that the two rear pintle hooks were tow hooks were missing when he got it. But it's pretty cool. You can see from the paint job there, boy, they really slopped it on there. It's got a lot of, we call them hanging curtains. But now, on Jared's truck today, now these got the 6.2 liter diesel in it. And later, they came with the 6.5. But this one's got the 6.2. And if you'll notice, just over to the right of the rear battery there, it's got two batteries, 24 volt starting system. There's a fuel filter back there, and sometimes these will leak back through. You'll lose your fuel pressure from the pump, it'll go back to the tank. What we're going to be doing today is Jared's going to install a check valve, a one-way check valve. And we'll get a look at that in a minute. But now these things had two batteries, and they'd start off with 24 volts, and then it had a 12 volt charging system. And I'll do another zoom in on this tag, you know, if you guys want to pause the video and read some of the specs. But I really like these things. They're tough. They are. And Jared's got him one of these little handy steps here. And that thing is pretty tough. I mean, he outweighs me probably by about 50 pounds, and it holds him up pretty good. And I'm not a small fella myself. But this is the check valve he's going to install today. And yeah, it looks kind of like a fuel filter, but it's actually a one-way check valve. And we'll show you how this thing works. You see the arrow? It's got an arrow. This one's... The fuel flow goes the same way as the arrow is pointing, but it won't go the other way. So, put a little water through here, and that's just water. It's not fuel. and it runs through fine in the direction of the arrow. But let's see what happens if we go the opposite of the arrow. And no, nothing will come through there. See, it's got water to it, but or fuel, whatever, but it's not going through there. So that means this check valve is working like it's supposed to. So what we're going to do, this top fuel line, and this one's coming from the pump, and we're going to install a check valve between that fuel line and the connection at the fuel filter. And so what that'll do is keep that fuel from draining back into the tank. And, you know, if you have a problem with these, they want to drain back, and then the fuel filter maybe gets an air pocket in it, and so it makes them hard to start. Now, this one little modification will speed up your starting, and, you know, a lot easier on the equipment when it starts faster. If that starter has to grind and grind, you know, it's not good. You know, running juice out of your battery and it's putting more wear and tear. But he's just added a little extra piece of extra length of fuel line there. Not enough to make it kink up or anything, but get the arrow pointed up going towards the fuel filter because that's the direction of fuel flow. And this is actually another one we didn't. The other one we did for demonstration, we ran water through it, so we didn't want to take a chance on getting any water in his fuel. So he just used one of the others that he's purchased. And we've got Andy doing the camera work, Jared turning the wrenches, and get that clamp tight there. Oops, sorry guys, I should have cut this part out. Cut to the end, but that's okay. All right. Sounds good. Ooh. Military has arrived. I want to show another clip of this little step thing. Jared's worried by this thing. So, you know, if you got one of these tall trucks, guys, it'd be worth your while to check it out. And that's all I got for today. So thanks for hanging out with me. We'll see you next time.